Sancho. When you are a man, sometimes you wear stretchy pants. In your room, it's for fun.
We interrupt this program to give you a bulletin just received from one of our naval units at sea. A large object traveling at supersonic speed is headed over the North Atlantic toward the east coast of the United States.
An unidentified object was picked up 200 miles southwest of Point Barrow, Alaska.
Shall we report it, sir?
What, that we're being invaded by little green men from outer space?
Flying saucers have invaded our planet.
It was a saucer. A flying saucer.
Talk to evidence these creatures have scientific knowledge far in advance of our own.
We've come to this planet looking for intelligent life. Oops, we made a mistake.
We're back. Welcome once again to the podcast that showcases humans behaving badly. This is why the aliens don't come. My name is Brendan Millett, and with me is the shameless Twitter whore, Michelle Poitras.
T-I-W-T-A-D-C! You know you missed us, bitches.
I hate you so much.
Revenge, baby.
Oh, what, for the poop segment last week? Wait for it.
Oh. He's doing this because horrifying me gets the best reactions.
You didn't think that segment was the shit? Oh, the look on her face right now.
Femrage! No, this is not. This is just like human normal rage because it's just like.
Not Hulk smash, just. Hulk poop. You imagine how big the Hulk's poop must be?
I try not to.
I never thought of that. Would it be green? Don't look at me like that.
This is as bad as...
This is audio. Stop doing it with facial expressions.
This is seriously as bad as fucking Mallrats when he wouldn't stop asking about the superhero dongs.
That's true. I'm obsessed with superhero poop, apparently.
Awesome.
Well, wait, go to Taco Bell.
Well, wait, so then when Superman takes a dump, just shoot through, like, all the way through, like, to the planet's core? Just
probably.
Not stop?
Yeah. Can the flies land on it? Can they eat Kryptonian poop?
It never stops long enough. Oh, is it just, true. Like, rocketed out, like...
If he, like, instead of, like, pointing his butt down, if he pointed it up, he could put it in orbit.
Probably.
The last turd of Krypton. I did not mean to take this far. We just kind of went there.
Does Spider-Man just, like, poop webs? Like, that must get really inconvenient.
Talk about high fiber.
Oh.
Dad joke.
Oh.
We really do need a dad joke segment. I got to get working on that.
Yeah, we'll think about that.
Yeah, dad jokes and femrage. That's like our superhero names.
Yeah.
I'm dad joke, you're femrage.
Definitely.
Yeah, like Batman and Robin.
When I'm not being like night pain.
And I'm not being back pain.
Very nice.
But anyway, thank you for joining us again, folks. Do follow us on Twitter. Please join our Facebook group and send us anything you got to be read on the show. Any kind of drinking stories, crazy ex stories, poop stories,
geeky stories,
anything you got, even if it doesn't fit into a segment we've done before, send it to us.
That's why we have the general stupid people category.
Exactly. And names will be omitted to protect both the innocent and the guilty. Mm-hmm. As we've done in previous stories that have been about each other, you know, in some cases, because as I've said before, we're not part of the solution. We are equally part of the problem.
Oh, absolutely.
But somehow we feel qualified to pass judgment on the rest of humanity.
Well, no, because it's that whole, like, takes one to know one logic.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
I should know. We can smell our own.
Exactly.
Yeah, exactly. But one thing we have kept that we do each and every week is, of course, headlines.
I said the headlines. Headlines. Have you heard it? Headlines. Headlines. Hit it.
He's laughing already.
These are good.
He's laughing already.
You remember that headline about a few weeks back? It was the tornado that ripped through the graveyard, and it said dozens dead or something like that. And so we were speculating, does it count the corpses?
I think so.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. This is kind of in the same vein. What the fuck? Dead man found in graveyard. Actually, no, this is more appropriate to the feds raid gun store, find weapons. Of course you found a dead man. You're going to find lots of dead men in a graveyard.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, this one was presumably above ground. But still...
I was going to make the joke, but that's what happens when you go digging around.
Now joke. You're making dad jokes. Wait, if you're a woman, is it a mom joke?
I don't know, maybe.
I guess, I don't know.
I don't know.
But, yeah, dead man found in graveyard. Choose your words more carefully, people.
Yeah.
This one, I need this one explained to me. I really do. I don't understand how this was even questioned. It does involve poop.
Of course it does.
Manure is not a health food.
I just threw up in my mouth a little.
I did a little too.
That's again up there with like, do you know when a tube of preparation age says do not eat this? Like, yeah. Because that means you know someone tried it.
Right. I've heard the story about that really expensive coffee that like some kind of weasel eats, and they poop out the beans. And they take the beans out, clean them off, sterilize them, and they sell it for like $600 an ounce or some shit.
Nope.
But you don't. But they're not eating the actual poop.
I don't care. But if anything was ever touching poop, I'm never touching
it. I am right there with you. I wouldn't drink that. Are you kidding me? No way. I'm just saying it exists. But who thought manure was food, one.
A.
And B, health food.
Yeah, I really just think it should read manure is not food. Food.
Poop is not food.
Nope.
No. That was... Did you get that?
No.
You don't remember? I think it was a old Campbell's jingle. Soup is good food. You don't remember that?
No.
Oh, God, we're old.
Sorry.
Anyway. This one... What the tits on toast does this even mean?
Okay.
Physics... not physics. Excuse me. Psychics predict world didn't end yesterday. I've heard of having the gift of sight, but the gift of hindsight? They did something like that on South Park with a superhero called Captain Hindsight. He didn't actually save anybody, but he showed up at the disaster to tell them how it could have been prevented.
Oh, Lord.
You... What? Predict and yesterday, by their definitions, should not appear in the same sentence.
There's a Fall Out Boy lyric for this.
There is? Of course there is.
Oh, yeah.
I'm full of poop jokes. You're full of Fall Out Boy references, so have at it.
Yeah. What is it? I'm looking forward to the future, but my eyesight is going bad, and this crystal ball is always cloudy, except for when you look into the past.
You know what's funny is that that's very similar to what my senior quote was in my high school yearbook, which was, life can only be understood backwards, but it must be lived forwards.
Which is true.
It's kind of meaning the same thing.
Yeah.
But Patrick Stump just said it far more poetically.
Exactly.
Yeah. Like he does.
Well, technically Pete said it.
Okay.
Because he's Patrick. No, because Pete wrote it.
Because he's Pete.
No, just because Pete writes the lyrics.
I know!
Patrick just rearranges them like fridge magnet poetry into something that can be workable into a song.
Fridge magnet poetry. I'd go see a band called Fridge Magic Poetry.
Fridge Magic Poetry.
That has officially turned into a thing. I say that every week now. One of us blurts something out and goes, I'd go see a band called X, Y, and Z, you know?
I would go see a band called X, Y, and Z.
There is a band called X, Y, Z. Well, at least there was in the 80s.
There's a song called X, Y,
Z. No, there was a band.
That's Y, Y, Z. I'm sorry.
They were a one-hit wonder. I forget what the hit was, but they were a hair band.
X, Y, Z. Okay, I don't remember.
I'm the only one who remembers obscure hair bands.
That's true.
Like, they might have played at the Whiskey A Go-Go once in 1987, and I remember them. It's fucking ridiculous.
Totally.
This one, I didn't catch it at first. Volunteers search for old Civil War planes. Think about that.
As opposed to new Civil War planes?
Civil War took place in the 1860s.
Before there was flight.
Decades before airplanes.
There's that too.
I can only assume they're not referring to the American Civil War.
They must not be.
I hope. But yeah. You know what? It's funny. I didn't catch it. I just saw war and planes, and I just went, why is this funny? And then I went, Civil War. Wait, what? What?
See, I just went with the whole, like, old Civil War planes. And, like, anything Civil War is going to be old. Why? They're new Civil War shit?
Only in reenactments.
I guess.
You know?
Yeah.
But now, this final one this week, this needs to be the title of a movie. Because I would watch this movie.
I'm sure.
And I've watched movies with similar titles, because as you know, I've done and may start doing again a web series called Grindhouse Guy, where I review and make fun of cheesy exploitation movies from like the 60s, 70s, and occasionally 80s. This sounds like an exploitation movie title.
Okay.
China Ferrari Sex Orgy Death Crash. I want to see that movie.
China Ferrari Sex Orgy Death Crash?
I want to see that movie. If that movie doesn't exist, I'm writing it.
Oh my god.
Would you watch that movie?
Totally.
I mean, I once watched a movie called Blood Orgy of the Leather Girls.
That movie has to be exactly 10 seconds. A bunch of Chinese people having an orgy in a Ferrari that crashes. That's it. That is it. And they have to crash into the Great Wall of China. That's the movie. Credits.
And they didn't even get to eat the crab rangoons.
Black. Credits.
If I could afford to purchase and destroy a Ferrari for the purposes of a motion picture, I would shoot that movie.
Absolutely.
China Ferrari Sex Orgy Death Crash. That's either a movie or a really long band name.
I would go see that band.
If it was a band name, I would shorten it to Sex Orgy Death Crash.
Oh no, Chinese Ferrari Sex Orgy Death Crash. Actually, it sounds like a fucking Fall Out Boy song title. Like, they have those
names. It kind of does.
Yeah. Pete Wentz, are you listening?
Write that shit.
Write that shit.
If you write that song, I will never give her one iota of shit about being obsessed with Fall Out Boy ever again, and I will be at every show with her. Just to hear that song.
That would be amazing. It will be your biggest hit.
I will join the cult of Fall Out Boy if Pete writes that song.
Victory!
Good luck with that.
Victory!
You know, when we get done with this, Michelle is going to be tweeting the shit out of that.
I totally am. And all of my Fall Out Boy bitches are going to be tweeting this with me, because we have to get this going.
Oh my god.
That is going to be the longest hashtag ever.
Can you have a hashtag that long?
Sure.
Twitter has all those character limits.
Chinese Ferrari Sex Orgy Death Crash. That's less than 140 characters.
What have we done? What have we perhaps wrought upon the world? But then again, I don't know if Patrick Stump would be willing to sing a song that has the words sex orgy in the title.
Oh no, he totally would.
He would?
Oh, he wrote a song and sang. Well, he didn't write it, but he sang a song called Blue Rabbits Fucking.
Oh, okay. Well, never mind. Well, you're always telling me how bashful the dude is.
No, no, no. He's bashful in, like, in real life, IRL. But, like...
Don't speak to me in Twitter speak.
He's bashful in real life, like, when he talks to people. Mm-hmm. On stage, when you give him shit to sing, he'll just sing it.
Okay.
I mean, some of the words to, like, some of the songs. I mean, American Beauty, American Psycho is like, us, we were pity sex, nothing more, mm-hmm. nothing less. Like...
By the way, we get royalties. If they write that song.
Totally.
Oh, yeah. Copyright. Brendan Millett and Michelle Poitras, 2015.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. That would be the best Fall Out Boy song ever.
Royalty rate negotiable. Anyway. So, I thought I would try out something a little new this week, like I did last week with the poop segment.
Well, wait. For royalties, can I accept sexual favors?
You'll have to take that up with Patrick and Pete. I'm not interested.
Oh.
I think Mrs. Stump might object.
Megan Camper might object, too. Pete's girlfriend, fiancé, whatever she is.
So as I was saying, I wanted to try something out new this week, like I tried the poop thing out last week. And one of the reasons I think maybe the aliens don't come is some of the things our offspring just blurt out. Not because they're stupid or crazy, but because they just don't know any better. So I want to call this From the Mouths of Babes.
Tell Mommy again what you said you were going to do to him if he came here.
I said I'm going to kick his ass.
Oh.
Now, this was inspired by a friend of mine's four-year-old son. Now, I'm not putting any of the stuff he said into the segment because I haven't discussed it with her, so I'm not going to do that.
Sure.
But he's quite precocious and articulate sometimes beyond his years. And so I tried to find stuff like that. Again, stuff kids say, but they don't know any better, and they don't know to not be so blunt.
Right.
So here's an exchange between a six-year-old boy and his dad. Dad, can we get a cat? Me. Your mom is allergic to cats, so no. son. When mom dies, can we get a cat? Me. Sure.
Oh.
Wow, mom must be a bitch.
Wow. I have a friend who's a nanny. I bet she has some good ones.
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, I had a feeling we were talking about the same friend.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. Yeah, I'm sure she's posted a few good ones.
Yeah, we'll have to discuss with her whether she minds if we use some.
Yeah, well, it's not like we're going to use the kid's name or anything.
No, of course not.
But this one, what the hell? Oh, my God. This morning, my wife told my 3-year-old daughter that owls are nocturnal. My daughter responded, yes, owls are not turtles.
That's incredible.
Did you ever have anything like that as a kid that, like, you heard a word, but then, actually, you did. You told me about this once. Your mother, you would act up, and either your mother or your dad, probably your mom, would say to you, Michelle, behave, and you responded with?
I'm being have.
Like being have was a state of being, not behavior.
Right, I didn't understand
that. You should be have.
I thought have was an adjective.
Exactly.
I'm being have.
So the next one, my 4-year-old son was in the bathroom with the door closed. I knocked and said, what's going on in there? His reply, nothing, it's just me and my penis.
That's incredible. That is amazing.
A little young for that. If he was a little older, you know, he might be saying that for different reasons.
Well, yeah, no, but no, the fascination with the penis starts so young, and that's never true. Stops.
And I said I wasn't going to say anything about my friend's son because I haven't discussed it with her, but she would be cool with this. Okay. We were at the park like a week or two ago, and he was like climbing on this, you know, like pyramid of ropes thing that was like so cool, and we didn't have it as a kid. And he's climbing down. And he was kind of straddling, like, if he slipped, he would have, you know...
Knocked his junk.
Yeah, he would have, you know, hurt his bits. So, she actually says, watch your penis. He's old enough to know it's funny, because he looked up and was like... And I started laughing so hard. Four years old, and he knows that's funny. This is a brief one.
Okay.
I was on the phone with my wife discussing dinner plans, and my 7-year-old informed us that, quote, salad is ruining my life. It can't all be chicken nuggets and macaroni and cheese, kid.
Oh, seriously. Although, wouldn't that be nice?
You gotta eat something green now and again.
Oh, my God. Salad is ruining my life.
That would be an album title right there.
That would be an Angry Salad album title.
God, Angry Salad. If anybody else remembers Angry Salad, email us.
Yeah, you'll become automatically our new best friend.
Oh, yeah, we told a story about them many weeks ago.
Many moons ago, yeah, yes. Yeah, yeah.
And finally this week, from the mouths of babes, I gave my son a timeout from swords, lightsabers, guns, and Thor hammers due to him becoming too violent and aggressive. After about 10 minutes of quiet, I went to check on him and found him building with his Legos. After I told him I was proud of him for listening, I asked him what he was building. This would be my kid if I ever had one. He told me he was building an ultimate Lego weapon so that he could destroy me.
Oh my God, it's Dewey Griffin!
I'm building the ultimate Lego weapon so I can destroy you.
Silence, why
I think he may have missed the point, but at least he's persistent. And finally this week. Hi, Michelle.
Hi.
You love me, right?
Maybe. That's conditional.
I did it again. I didn't explain my reasoning behind this segment last week, but a good reason the aliens don't come is because people with juvenile senses of humor, like me, seem to find bodily functions hysterical.
Oh no.
Oh yes. Oh, it's no. Back. It's accidental poop.
Make poop. Everybody in the club wanna make poop. Everybody in their car wanna make poop. Everybody going on a date, make poop. Everybody running late, just make poop.
I hate you.
You're really gonna hate me for this first one.
I hate you.
I should rename the segment Accidental Poop # I Hate You.
Yeah.
So this woman says, Oh, no. Oh, yeah. No, okay. This woman says this. When I was about 3 years old, I took my poop and smeared it on my mom's mouth, saying, "Here, mommy, some chocolate for you." She told me she brushed her teeth and washed her mouth like 20 times. Her heart was in the right place.
Oh, no. But her ass wasn't. No. Kids are so fucking gross.
It's the thought that counts.
Kids are so fucking
gross. What was that movie where I saw the trailer? I think Tina Fey was in it, and the woman was taking care of these kids, and the kid had something brown on their head, and she goes, "Is that chocolate or poop?" And she licks it and goes, "It's chocolate." And I think it was Tina Fey goes, "What if that had been poop?" What was that movie? It's going to drive me nuts.
Probably Baby Mama?
That sounds right. That sounds right. Oh, jeez.
Oh.
This one's a little less disgusting.
Okay.
A little less. It does not involve poop consumption, at the very least.
Oh, all right.
My aunt was at Walmart, and as another show I like to listen to is fond of saying, there's nothing sexy at the Walmart.
No,
that's and true. My aunt was at the Walmart and had the classic, a little more came out than I was expecting moment, and sure as shit, she says, she sharted herself. And what's better than you sharting yourself? Wearing white capri pants and sharting yourself.
No.
She then marched right into Walmart with her mud butt and her grandchildren and proceeded to tell everyone she had sat in brown water. Her mortified 10-year-old grandchild said, "Really, Grandma? Brown water? That's the best you could come up with? Everyone knows you sharted." That should have been in the Mouths of Babes segment. In the Mouths of Babes,
yeah.
You know, I knew this woman many years ago, briefly, who was in professional wrestling. She was a pro wrestler. And she told a story about a guy who was wearing white tights who got body slammed so hard he shit himself in the middle of the ring in white tights. So she said 20 minutes before every one of her matches, she takes Imodium so that it won't happen to her.
Oh, wow.
Can you imagine that? That guy's done.
Yeah, pretty
forever,
much.
Forever, he'll be like, you know, stinky britches, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Always going to be stinky britches. Yeah, totally.
Exactly.
Yeah, you kind of never
live. Poor dude.
You kind of never live that down once that happens to you.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
And finally, this week, this is the creme de la crap.
Creamy, delicious poop.
Thank you, Triumph the Insult Comic Dog. I think, wasn't that Triumph?
Yep.
Yes, it was.
Because he said his New Year's resolution was he was going to stop eating his own poop, and he had the "I can't believe it's not poop."
That's right. I don't know how true this is, but I heard this one about a girl who had a one-night stand with a guy. In the morning, the guy left for work and let her sleep in. Very nice of him. Just asking her to lock the door behind her on the way out. When she did wake up, she took a dump in the toilet, but it wouldn't flush for some reason. She didn't want to leave the shit in the toilet unflushed, so she took a plastic bag and picked up the poop and put it in the bag. She then went to the kitchen and wrote a really long note about how she enjoyed the night and left him her phone number, asking him to call again. And then she left. She locked the door and closed it behind her. As soon as the door closed, she realized she had left the plastic bag of poop on the counter, where she set it down while writing the note. She had no way to get back in. She left. So some guy came back after work to find a note from his one-night stand and a bag of poop on his kitchen counter.
Oh.
Just send flowers. You know? I want to find out who posted this online because I want to know if he called her again.
Yeah.
You wouldn't call again.
No.
I sure as shit would not call again, pardon the pun.
Yeah, no.
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 No. Yeah. When you care enough to send the very best. No.
No. Just... I hate you.
Boop.
So very, very much.
Plop.
Gross.
Whatever. All right. I'll leave out the poop segment from now on.
Unless everyone else wants it.
Yeah, if you guys actually like this segment, let me know. If not, we'll replace it with something else. But I took a chance on it for a couple of weeks because I think poop jokes are funny. Apparently, I'm wrong.
Oh, now you're just figuring that out?
If a man is standing in the woods by himself and there's no woman around to hear him, is he still wrong?
Of course he is.
Because, man, that's why.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I guess this is a whole other reason why the aliens don't come. Guys like me who enjoy poop jokes. Anyway, join us next week, folks, for another riveting podcast, presumably poop-free, unless you guys deem otherwise. Presumably blessedly free of feces. This is why the aliens don't come. This podcast is the property of Brendan Millett, all rights reserved. All music and audio clips used in this podcast are the property of their respective copyright owners. This podcast was hosted by Brendan Millett and Michelle Poitras. Opening theme composed and performed by Chris Lott. Official logo by Michael Magario at Pixel Pusher Studio. If you've enjoyed this podcast, join our Facebook group at facebook.com/groups/thisiswhythealiensdon'tcome, all one word.